Hello everyone, in this video I am going to discuss the introduction of vapor power cycle. Vapor power cycle where the working fluid is considered as the water vapor. So as you can see the name vapor power cycle. So cycle which is getting the power from vapor. So this is the general meaning of vapor power cycle. This cycle we can define as a complete process for the production of work. So the cycle which is getting power from vapor is known as vapor power cycle. Now from where this vapor is coming? So vapor is basically coming from main source, that is called water. So water vapor which is running a cycle, or the water vapor which is transferring heat to devices and it is converting into work. So that particular cycle is called vapor power cycle. So vapor power cycle is basically a type of power cycle only, where the working fluid is what? Where the working fluid is water vapor, which is coming from water, or which we are getting from the water. So if we talk about the power cycle, so power cycle is what? Power cycle where the heat energy which comes from the burning of fuel, it will convert into work, where the working fluid is performing a complete process. So what is power cycle? Power cycle, here working fluid will perform the complete cycle, and here we will get the heat energy by burning the fuel and it will further convert into work. So here what is happening? We are getting heat from one particular source and we are converting this heat into work with the help of working fuel or working fluid. So this is the main process of power cycle. Heat is converting into work with the help of working fluid, so that is called power cycle. Now why it is called vapor power cycle? Because this working fluid we are considering as water vapor or water, that is why it is called vapor power cycle. Suppose if we are using any kind of gas as a working fluid, so it will become gas power cycle. So by changing the type of working fluid, we can change the type of power cycle. So here our main working fuel or working fluid is water vapor, so that is why it is called vapor power cycle. Now if we talk about vapor power cycle, so working fluid is here. What is the working fluid? The working fluid is always considered as water. And water, here we cannot use water directly for the power generation. First we need to change the phase of water. So this water will further convert into steam or water vapor. So we cannot directly use this water. So what is happening here? The water is changing the phase. So there are various phase change we have to consider during the whole process. So here water in the form of different phases we have to use to generate the power or to convert heat into the work. So this is the basic working of the vapor power cycle. Now here, if we talk about the example, so example is mainly we can take as steam power plant. So steam power plant work on vapor power cycle. The working of the steam power plant we can define on the basis of vapor power cycle. So here in this diagram you can see, this is the diagram. In this diagram we will define the simple working of steam power plant. So here you can see there are number of parts mentioned here: boiler, turbine, heat exchanger or condenser, and compressor. So let me write down the processes. So suppose this is process number 1, this is process number 2, this is process number 3, and this is process number 4. So here we will divide complete process into 4 processes or 4 states. So boiler, turbine, condenser and compressor are the main parts or devices of this steam power plant. Now how the steam power plant works, or what is the basic theory behind the working of the स्टीम पावर प्लांट और दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड थर्मल पावर प्लांट. सो हियर आई विल टेल यू द कंप्लीट वर्किंग ऑफ द थर्मल पावर प्लांट, हाउ इट एक्चुअली वर्क. सो हियर यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड द बॉयलर. सो बॉयलर मीन्स वॉट, वेयर द फ्यूल और द फ्लूइड बॉयल. बेसिकली इट इज बॉइलिंग द फ्लूइड. सो वॉट इज द फ्लूइड वी आर यूजिंग? वी आर यूजिंग द फ्लूइड एज वॉटर. सो बॉयलर विल बॉइल द वॉटर एंड फ्रॉम द बॉयलर वी विल गेट हाई टेम्परेचर एंड हाई प्रेशर स्टीम. नाउ हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू बॉइल दिस वॉटर? सो दिस वॉटर विल बॉइल विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम एक्सटर्नल हीट सोर्स. So this external heat source we can take as furnace. So from furnace we will get the heat. That heat will boil the water here and this water will convert into the steam or water vapor. And here what is happening? Heat addition. So Qin, this Qin is representing what? It is representing the heat addition. So this heat is generating the high pressure, high temperature steam, and this particular heat we are getting from external heat source that is called the furnace. So now here in this process, when we will get the high pressure, high temperature steam from the boiler, it will transfer to the turbine. So this high pressure, high temperature steam is, it will transfer to the turbine for further process. So this process we are considering as process number one, transfer of high pressure, high temperature steam to the turbine. And this particular process is defined as process of heat addition. So this Qin we are considering as the process or the first process for this steam power plant. So this high pressure, high temperature steam from the boiler, it will transfer to the turbine. And in this turbine, the steam will expand. And how it will expand? So this turbine consists number of parts. So it consists one rotor or impeller. And there are number of blades situated on this particular rotor or impeller. So what will happen? This high pressure, high temperature steam with high pressure, it will hit the blades of the rotor. And what will happen? Because of the pressure of this steam, this rotor will rotate and this rotor will rotate and it will further connect it to the shaft. So this shaft will transfer the power to another device. This particular shaft is connected to another device like generator. So what will happen here? The high pressure, high temperature steam will hit the blades of the rotor, rotor will rotate, it is connected to the shaft and that shaft will get the power from the rotation of rotor and that power will be transferred to another device for another purpose. So what is happening here? We are giving work to another device. So what is happening here? Work output we are getting. What we are getting here? Work output. So with the help of turbine, we will get some work output. So this particular work or work output is called turbine work. So here what is happening? The boiler is going to transfer the high pressure, high temperature steam to the turbine and that steam is going to expand in the turbine. What will happen here? Because of the shape of the turbine, it will expand and this expansion of heat we will consider in the turbine and it will produce some work that is called the turbine work or we can say as the shaft work. So here we are getting the work output from the turbine. Now after this particular part, the remaining heat which is unused, it will transfer to the condenser. So this is our process number two. So 1 to 2 we are considering as the heat addition is happening in the boiler, then it is transferred to the turbine and the remaining heat which is unused heat in the turbine, it will transfer to the condenser. So from 1 to 2 we are considering expansion of the steam only. Now the remaining heat will transfer to the condenser and it will condense here and it will convert into the water. So here water vapor is converting again into water. So the steam leaves the turbine from here, the remaining steam, and it will transfer to the condenser where steam condensed, and here the temperature and pressure will be lower compared to other devices. So here we will get the lower pressure, lower temperature steam, and it will condense into water and it will reject heat. So the heat output we are getting in the process of condenser. So this Q out is what? It is the heat output or heat rejection. So heat rejection we are considering in the condenser. And the steam which is at the low temperature, low pressure will convert into the water. And when we get the water here in the condenser, so this water will pump back to the boiler with the help of compressor. So here we are compressing the water. So here we have to do some work over this particular part. So this is represented as compressor work or work input. This is defined as what? Work input. So we have to do some work over this device to pump the water from condenser to the boiler. Now this remaining water will use here in boiler to convert into the steam. Now that steam we will transfer again to the turbine, and this turbine will expand the steam. It will produce the shaft work. Then remaining heat will again transfer to the condenser, and then it will convert into the water. Then it will goes back to the boiler with the help of compressor or the pump. So this is the cyclic process. This process will continue. So this is what? This is a type of cyclic process. Here the water will continuously convert into steam. It will expand, then it will condense, then it will compress, and then it will use continuously. So this is what? This is a cyclic process. So in cyclic process, if the fluid is undergoing, or we can say the fluid is undergoing a cyclic process, in that condition, there will be no net change in internal energy over the cycle. And here the net heat transfer as the heat during the cycle, it will be equal to net energy transfer as work. And this work we are getting from fluid. So what is happening here? There is no internal energy we are considering, no net change in internal energy, only net heat energy transfer as heat. It will converting into work which is getting from the fluid. So net heat transfer as heat will be equal to net energy transfer as work. So in the cyclic process, we can write as Q for the cyclic process, it will be equal to W net for the cycle. So summation of Q, or this is also defined as Q net. So summation of Q net for the cyclic process will be equivalent to summation of W net for the cyclic process, where this W net we can define as the difference of turbine work and the pump work. So this is our turbine work, and here this compressor work, or we can define as pump work. So net work done will be what? WT minus WP, which is the net work done we are getting from the steam power plant. So here this Q net we can define as Q1 minus Q2, that will be equal to WT minus WP. So here WT is what? It is the turbine work or work transfer from working fluid. And WC or WP is pump work, work transfer to the working fluid. So this is all about for the cyclic process. And here Q1 and Q2 is what? Q1 is the heat transfer to the working fluid and Q2 is the heat rejected to the working fluid or heat rejected by the working fluid. So basically Q1 is what? Heat addition I have written here. So Q in we will consider as the Q1 and Q out we will consider as Q2. So these terms we can define for the cyclic process where the water is converting into the steam and then steam is producing some work as the shaft work and the heat is directly converting into work. So this is about the vapor power cycle where the working fluid is vapor or water. Suppose if we want to represent the working of the steam power plant on TS diagram. So suppose here we have TS diagram. TS diagram is what? Temperature entropy plot. So temperature entropy plot we will define on the basis of working of the steam power plant. So suppose here you can see this is the dome. This dome is representing what? This dome is representing the phase change of working fluid. So here this is representing what? This is a dome and this dome is usually represent the phase change of the working fluid. So every phase of the working fluid, that is the water, we will define on the basis of this curve of the dome. So here in this particular dome, inside this dome we will consider a region which is the combination of liquid and vapor. This we have learned in the phase change of the pure substance. So inside the dome it will be liquid plus vapor region. Now right side of it will be completely vapor or purely superheated steam. So here in this right side the steam will be in the vapor form or it will be purely superheated steam. And at the left side, we will consider compressed liquid. So this is the liquid region. This is liquid plus vapor region. And this is vapor region. Now this line, this particular line over the dome is represented as saturated liquid line where the liquid will start converting into the vapor. And here this line is known as the saturated vapor line where the vapor will completely form and it will start superheating from here because the temperature is going beyond the 100 degree centigrade. And where these two lines will meet, that is called the critical point where temperature will be maximum. So this is about the pure substance diagram or phase change of the pure substance or any kind of working fluid. So as per this diagram, in this boiler, we are producing high pressure, high temperature steam and this high pressure, high temperature steam is transferred to the turbine and the turbine will expand the steam and it will transfer, the remaining heat will transfer to the condenser. So at condenser, we are considering low pressure and low temperature steam. So boiler will be at high pressure, high temperature. And the condenser will be at the low pressure and low temperature region. So in steam power plant, this is a cyclic process. So steam power plant basically operate in a closed cycle because here some working fluid which is used throughout the cycle or the process. So the chemical composition of the working fluid does not change in this particular region. It will remain same. So this is a cyclic process and here this particular process we are considering as a closed cycle because of the working fluid. If we are considering open cycle, so here working fluid will not be in the liquid form or it will not be in the vapor form. Here because of the working fluid, we are considering this complete cycle as the closed cycle and chemical composition should not change. Chemical composition should be same here. Now coming back to the temperature entropy plot. So I have told you about the phase change of the working fluid. Now in this particular curve, you can see this curve is representing the pressure in the boiler and this is constant pressure curve. Here you can see this particular line. So if we form a curve here in the form of various properties. So let me extend this line. So you will understand better. So suppose we have pressure here at this point, because this is a TS diagram, temperature entropy plot, so we can define only the values of temperature and entropy only. So suppose here if we want to define the pressure. So here you can see this is the curve, this is a dome basically, and here we are going to define the curve on the basis of different properties. So here you can see this particular curve, or this line or this curve, anything you can take. So this line is representing what? It is representing constant temperature. But here you cannot see the pressure will be variable or not. So in this particular condition, if we want to define the pressure, so pressure in the boiler, it will be at constant condition. The pressure will be at higher side, but there will be constant pressure here. So this particular curve will be defined as the constant pressure curve. But in this condition, you can see after this particular point, between this and this, the temperature is constant. But at this particular point, if you see the curve, so it is representing the increase in temperature. So the temperature is variable here. So here, in this particular condition, the pressure will be constant throughout, but from here to here, the temperature will be constant, and from this point, after this point, the temperature will be variable. So this particular curve is representing the variable temperature with constant pressure. Now the second curve is representing the pressure in the condenser. So here, from this point to this point, the pressure will be constant, or from this point the pressure will be constant, but temperature will increase from this point or beyond this particular point. Why? Because it is the superheated condition. It is what? It is the superheated condition. So here the pressure is constant and temperature is changing continuously. Now if we extend this constant temperature line here, from this point to this point, so it is intersecting this vertical temperature line. What is happening here? If we are extending this line, then it will intersect this vertical line. So this point is represented as the boiling temperature, TB. What is this? TB. So TB is what? TB is the boiling point of water. At this particular point, the water will boil. So, boiling point of water. And this boiling point of water we will define on the basis of pressure of boiler, corresponding to pressure of boiler. Now, similarly, here in condenser, if we extend this line further toward left, so we will define one temperature here. So it is defined as the TC, condenser temperature. It is known as the saturated temperature. So the TC is known as what? Condenser temperature or saturated temperature. And it will be corresponding to pressure of the condenser. Here this will be corresponding to pressure of boiler and this will be corresponding to pressure of temperature. So here what is happening? Heat is added by the boiler. So in this particular condition, we will consider heat addition through boiler, that is QB. And in this condition, the heat rejection, so it will be QC as the heat rejected by the condenser. So this is about the temperature pressure diagram or the variation of pressure and temperature. Now, if we define the complete cycle of the steam power plant, so it will be defined on the basis of four processes only. And here, this complete cycle is known as the theoretical cycle, which is representing the each and every phase of the steam power plant. So here, if we write down all the phases of the steam power plant, so it will be defined as, so this is our point 1, this is our point 2, this is our point 3, and this is our point 4. So in this particular condition, we can say, and the process is the cyclic process. So here, the cyclic process we can define on the basis of arrow. So this 1 and 2 is representing what? It is representing the expansion process. So it is called the isentropic expansion. Why? Because the entropy is constant here. This is the TS diagram. So this constant 1 to 4 is representing what? Constant temperature. Constant temperature we always defined as the heat addition. So heat will be added here in the form of Q. Now from point 1 to 2 we are considering the turbine process. So from 1 to 2 the steam will expand, and the steam will expand isentropically. So here we can write down this term as 1 to 2 as isentropic expansion. It is called isentropic expansion. Now from 2 to 3 what is happening? The 2 to 3 heat rejection is happening through the condenser. So it is called constant temperature heat rejection. So heat will be rejected in the form of Q2 and it will happen on constant temperature. So 2 to 3 is defined as what? Constant temperature heat rejection. Or constant temperature heat rejection we can say isothermal heat rejection also. Now from 3 to 4 we are considering compression of steam. So this compression of not complete steam, it can be the combination of water and water vapor, or it will completely convert into the water because of the condenser. So 3 to 4 we are considering as the isentropic compression to pump the water to the boiler. So 3 to 4 is defined as isentropic compression. And here the entropy will constant. Temperature will be variable, but entropy will be constant. Now here from 4 to 1, what will happen? Constant temperature heat addition into the boiler. So this 4-1 we are considering as constant temperature heat addition. So it will be what? It is also called isothermal heat addition. So this is what? This particular cycle is the theoretical thermodynamic cycle, and this cycle is independent of working fluid if we say. So this particular cycle we can define as theoretical cycle. And this theoretical cycle is usually independent of working fluid. So theoretical cycle we can compare with the ideal cycle also. But ideal cycle we usually defined as the Carnot cycle. Ideal cycle is what? Where we are getting 100% efficiency. So this particular cycle will be defined as Carnot cycle. But there is no engine can operate between two heat reservoirs can be more efficient than a Carnot engine operating between the same heat reservoir. So if we are using practical data, so we will get the actual cycle only. But if we are considering the ideal data, so we will get the ideal cycle, that is called as the Carnot cycle. So this is what the cycle is represented as, the thermodynamic theoretical cycle, which is independent of the working fluid, and this is the most efficient cycle for converting the thermal energy into work. But Carnot cycle cannot be achieved in reality because it's an ideal cycle. But the efficiency of the actual cycle we can improve by attempting the Carnot cycle more closely. So this is what, this particular cycle we are considering as the ideal cycle, which is working over the substance. Here we are considering a working substance which is getting heat. It is transferring the heat to a particular device, and that is producing a work or it is giving some work output. So here we are considering the heat transfer to a particular device, and that device is converting heat into work, and this is a cyclic process, so it will be continue. So here, if we want to talk about the steam power plant, so steam power plant can also operate on the Carnot cycle closely, but not as it is. So we can improve, we can do some improvement in a particular type of steam power plant to get the efficiency like Carnot cycle, but we cannot get 100% efficiency as Carnot cycle. We can try to get more efficiency by some improvement or by some changes. So here you can see this particular cycle. Now here you can see a process of the steam power plant where 1 to 2 is what? It is the isentropic expansion. 2 to 3 is constant temperature heat rejection. 3 to 4 is compression isentropic, and 4 to 1 is the heat addition at constant temperature. So 4 to 1 we are considering heat addition. 2 to 3 is the heat rejection. 1 to 2 is the turbine work, and 3 to 4 is the pump work or compressor work. So here let me write down the processes. 1 to 2 is isentropic expansion. 2 to 3 is constant temperature heat rejection. 3 to 4 is isentropic compression. And 4 to 1 is constant temperature heat addition. So there are four processes we are considering in the cycle of the steam power plant. And this is what? This is the TS diagram. So basically here, entropy at 1 to 2. Here you can see 1 to 2. So entropy at this particular point will be same, or it will be constant. And 3 to 4, it will again constant, because these two processes are what? Isentropic processes. So here we can say entropy at 1 and 2 will be equal, and 3 and 4 will be equal. So this is the ideal case, but practically the efficiency of the turbine and the pump is not 100%. So we will consider some losses here. Because of this particular condition, we are considering this condition as the ideal condition, but practically this condition is not possible. So here we will define some losses that will change the value of entropy. So here, if we define this particular process, suppose if we are considering 1, 2, 2 dash. Suppose this is 1 to 2 dash and then 3 to 4 dash. So 1 to 2 dash, 3, 4 dash. Suppose this is our ideal condition. This is what? This is our ideal condition. So here in this process, 1, 2, 2. This is isentropic compression. But in actual condition, if we are considering actual process, so this curve should not be a straight line. This curve will be like this. And this point I am marking as point 2. So this particular 1, 2 dash. So let me change the color so you will better understand. So this particular line, suppose this red line is representing the actual process. So 1 to 2 dash is represented as isentropic compression, where the entropy is constant. But in this curve, if we are defining actual process, so this curve should not be straight. So 1 to 2 dash is representing the actual expansion. 1 to 2 dash is representing what? Actual expansion. So in this expansion, we are considering two processes, 1 to 2 dash and 1 to 2. So in this condition, if we define entropy or any kind of other properties, so suppose if we are defining entropy, so H2 will be greater than H2 dash. H2 will be greater than H2 dash. Similarly, if we define in process 3 to 4, so 3 to 4 dash is defined as isentropic expansion. So in 3 to 4 dash, this is representing the ideal condition. But if we want to define the actual condition, so in actual condition, we have to define this 3, 4 is not a straight line. It will be again a curve or some inclined line. So 3 to 4 we are defining as the expansion or the actual expansion or actual compression, basically it will be. So 3 to 4 will be the actual compression. So actual expansion will be 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 will be the actual compression. So if we want to define in this particular condition, we can also say this H4 is lesser than H4 dash, similar to this. Or if we define entropy, so S2 will be greater than S2 dash or S4 will be less than S4 dash. So if we want to define the work done during the process, so between 1 to 2 we are considering expansion work. So work done during process 1 to 2, work done will be what? First we will define the work done actual. So W actual or WT actual, it will be equivalent to what? H1 minus H2. And if we are defining isentropic or ideal, work done ideal or isentropic, so let me write down WT ideal. So it will be defined as H1 minus H2 dash. So if we define the efficiency, so efficiency will be what? It will be defined as actual work divided by isentropic work. So it will be defined as H1 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H2 dash. So where the isentropic work is greater than WT isentropic or ideal, it should be greater than actual work. So this is for the process 1 and 2. Similarly, if we define process 3, 4 and 3, 4 dash, so WP pump work actual will be what? Actual pump work will be defined as H4 minus H3. And the isentropic work we can define as what? It is defined as H4 dash minus H3. So the efficiency here will be defined as WP isentropic divided by WP actual. In that case, we'll get less than 100% efficiency. So it will be H4 dash minus H3 divided by H4 minus H3. So this is all about the efficiency comparison for the actual work and the isentropic work, or on the basis of actual work and isentropic work. So this is all about the introduction of vapor power cycle. Thank you so much.